Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gaming on Caffeine. My name is Isaac, and we are back for episode 17 of Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved Skyblock. Last episode, we were working on setting up our new auto spawner over here at the bottom of our old dropper spawner. And at the very end of last episode, we were struggling with getting a reusable safari net so that we could capture some Endermen, put them into the auto spawner, and actually start to spawn them, killing them with the grinder, and start to farm a couple of Enderpearls for later on in the game. And what I want to work on today's episode is getting those enderpearls through a bit of an unconventional way, and that is by using the alchemy catalyst, this guy over here, from Britannia underneath the mana pool. What we can do is we can throw gas tiers into the mana pool and get enderpearls back out of it. We are currently making gas tiers over here using the soul sand sifting system that we set up in the last episode, and so all we need to do is make ourselves the alchemical catalyst, and we are good to go. Unfortunately, it's not quite as easy as that, and if we look over here in the guide, the next quest line or the next like little tab here in the magic tree actually asks us to make the alchemy catalyst as part of making the next tier of blood orb required for blood magic, and so we're gonna have to go through a couple of steps here to actually get the alchemy catalyst up and running. But once it is up and running, we can actually make a bunch of new stuff using the alchemy catalyst, which is going to make life a lot easier in the future. For example, right now, if we want to get birch saplings, we already have a few, but to get these we had to use mutandis. In the future, we can use an alchemy catalyist and some spruce saplings in a mana pool to get birch saplings, to get spruce saplings. We could do the same thing with oak saplings, and so getting stuff like that is going to be a lot easier once we have this alchemy catalyst, and also it's going to allow us to turn the gas tiers into enderpearls so that we can use those enderpearls to make a reusable safari net, and then make almost as many enderpearls as we like using the auto spawner, and then go from there. So to make this thing, we need a few things. Living rock, we need 4 of those. That is fairly easy to do. We've got a bunch of living rock in our storage drawers. We need 1 block of blaze lamp, which is super easy to get. It's just 9 blaze rods. To get blaze rods, all we have to do is compress up some blaze powder. We need 2 of these alchemic chemistry sets. We've already got one of these, and another one is fairly easy to make. It's just a brewing stand in a blood altar with 2,500 life points. We need 1 Salus Mundus, which is made by smelting a balanced shard from Thorncraft. This is made by having fire, water, earth, order, and entropy aspects all in the cauldron and adding in an air shard. That gets to the balanced shard. We're going to smelt that to get some Salus Mundus. The hard part about this crafting recipe here is the golden chalk that we need from Witchery, because in order to get the golden chalk, we need to get ourselves a ritual chalk, and in order to get ritual chalk, we need Tears of the Goddess as well as this gypsum, and both of these require a distillery, and to power a distillery, we need an altar. So, the first thing we're gonna make is an altar from Witchery, and to do that, we need 6 of these altar blocks. What I've gone ahead and done between episodes is smelted up a couple more of these clay jars over here, and made sure that we have 2 Exhale of the Horned One, as well as 2 Breath of the Goddess, so that we can fairly easily go ahead and make this altar right off the bat. We have the 2 Exhale of the Horned One, 2 Breath of the Goddess. We should, I think, have enough stone in one of the barrels over here to make the 4 or 8 stone bricks that we need to actually get this thing up and running. Yep, we got 47 stone. That should be more than enough. Let's go ahead and do something like that. Grab 8 of those. And then all that we're missing is the 2 water bottles and the rowan wood. We have some rowan wood from the last time we did a little bit of witchery a couple of episodes back. And then finally, the water bottles. I'm fairly certain that we should have some bottles lying around somewhere. We do. And we've already got 1 water bottle filled, and we can take the second one here and fill it up in our unlimited water source. Once we've got all those things, we can come back over to our crafting table, and we should be able to craft up 2 sets of these altar bricks. Let's put you in the middle. Let's put the bricks either side. We'll put Breath of the Goddess and Exhale of the Horned One, as well as a little bit of water. That gets us 2. We are... Oh, my calculations are completely wrong. We're going to need 3 of these in order to get this to work, because the altar is a 2x3 block, and so what we're going to need to do is set it up something like this. Where do I want to put it? For now, I'm going to put it right here. It needs to be like this, but with 1 more set on the end. And so, what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to go away. I'm going to quickly grab 1 more Breath of the Goddess and 1 more Exhale of the Horned One, and I'll be back in a second. And a little while later, now that we've got 2 more of these altar blocks, we can take these over to the original 4, and once we put these last 2 down, it should form into the altar from Witchery, and it does. You'll see this nice little red carpet-type block appear on top of it there, and this is now the fully crafted altar from Witchery, which we're going to use to power our distillery, and to get some of the items that we need to make ourselves and the alchemy catalyst. So Next up on the list is the distillery itself to make this. If we look in here, we need one Order of Purity, one Whiff of Magic, three Mana Steel, two Gold, one Arcane Alembic, and one Attuned Stone. I think we've already got most of the stuff we need for this. We've already got a Whiff of Magic, I believe, over in this chest. Yeah, we do. We got one right there. In order to get an Order of Purity, we need to get a Hawthorn Sapling. And so to do that, we're going to have to get ourselves some more Mutandis. And once again, just cycle through all the plants until we get the Hawthorn Sapling and then smelt it down as we would with any other sapling in the Witch's Oven to try and get the Order of Purity. We also need the Mana Steel. Mana Steel should be fairly easy to come by. I did throw some call down before the episode started onto the Endor Flames over here. So making three Mana Steel should be fairly easy, and it actually was. We'll throw down a little bit more coal just to make sure that we have enough mana left in the mana pool for the rest of the episode. We then need two gold, which is easy enough. We need an Attuned Stone, which we did make, I believe, last time we did Witchery, because we needed this for the Blood Altar. That does also require another Whiff of Magic. Do we have two? We do have two, which is good, because I don't really want to have to make another one, although we do have Rowan Saplings lying around if we do have to make another one. And so to make ourselves another Attuned Stone, Bucket of Lava, Mana Diamond, and the Whiff of Magic, let's quickly grab a diamond and also, I guess, some more iron plates to make another bucket that we can fill up with lava from our crucibles around the corner. Let's quickly throw you into there. We have enough mana. Good stuff. Let's fill this up by one of the crucibles. Cool stuff as well. We should probably at some point, actually fairly soon, set up a tank to actually store all this lava, because right now we're limited to how much all of these crucibles can hold, which is a fair amount. Each one of these can hold 8,000 millibuckets, and so having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these does allow us to hold up to 40 buckets of lava at any given time. But considering how easy it was for us to make the tank over here, I think it's the hardened portable tank that can hold 128 buckets worth, we should probably set one of those up and stick it down on the end of the crucible line somewhere, just so we can store all of our lava in one easy, convenient place. But now we've got that, we can come back over to any of our crafting tables, craft all of those up like so. Lava at the bottom, mana diamond in the middle, and whiff of magic at the top. That gets us the attuned stone. We then need the two gold, which we can take as well. And then the other hard bit about this, apart from the fact that we're going to have to get the hawthorn saplings to make the Order of Purity, is this guy in the middle, the Arcane Alembic. In order to make that, let me quickly just throw in these mana steel ingots here. In order to make that, we are going to need 5 iron ingots, a bucket, a golden ingot, some V in our wand. I think we should have 5 air and 5 water already in our wand from my previous trips down to our nearby aura nodes, as well as a V filter. To make this, we need 2 gold and 1 silverwood plank. To get silverwood planks, we need to get silverwood logs into a mana pool, and to get silverwood logs, we need to take a normal birch log, throw it into the crucible with, I think that's 3 arbor, 1 procantio, and 1 order. Now, one thing I have done since the end of last episode is gone around with my thermometer, which, by the way, I've added to this little rack over here. This is kind of my rack of magical tools. We've got our thermometer, our Thermonomicon, our Britannia wand, our Divisin sigil, and also our blood orb, so we can get like all of our magic tools fairly easily without having to dig through all those chests, because they don't really warrant their own storage drawer, because storage drawers are made to hold a lot of one item, and these are kind of just single items that don't warrant a full storage drawer. But I also don't want to have them just hidden away in random chests, so I've set this up for now. These are just some drying racks from Tinker's Construct, real easy to make. It's just 3 slabs put together in the crafting table, and then you can put anything you want up there. But what we're going to do is we're going to make this thing here. So if we look at our Thermonomicon, because I have searched and scanned quite a lot of stuff since the end of last episode, we should be able to just look in here under aspects of magic and then flick across, and we should be able to hover over some of these items to find out which items contain arbor, for example. So here we can see that pretty much every item that contains wood also contains arbor. And so if we come on over and grab some of these oak logs, we should be able to get that 3 arbor fairly easily just using some of these. You can see if we press shift whilst hovering over it, one oak log contains 4 arbor. We then need 1 procantio and 1 order. Let's quickly look back in the Thermonomicon here. Procantio is found in blood altars, ender pearls, blood orbs, auto spawners. It's not found in the best of places. We might actually have to use our one ender pearl here in order to get the silverwood log required. Is there a way, real quick actually, for me to get a silverwood sapling? I think there is, but I think it's way out of our price range right now. Like, if you look in here, I think, if I'm not mistaken, there should be a section for the sky, which is this one here, and then I'm fairly certain within this there is probably one that allows us to unlock silverwood saplings. But if I remember correctly from previous mod pack, Silverwood saplings are extremely hard to make, and so we're not going to be able to do that this episode. Instead, we're going to have to use our one and only Ender Pearl to get the Precantia required in order to make all of this stuff in the Crucible, so we really don't want to get this wrong anytime soon. So before we start making this, let's quickly look at what we need to get ourselves some order. We can find order in lead, refined iron, and storage drawers or storage controllers. I think we're going to use lead because we have a lot more lead than we do refined iron. Lead contains one order. Did we only need one to make this work? We did. One order, one Precantia, and one arbor. And so, if we throw all of those together with one birch log, we should be pretty much good to go. I've already got some birch logs in my inventory because I was doing a little bit of birch farming before the episode started to get enough of the saplings for the Breath of the Goddess, I think it was. So, if we throw down all of these into here, let's not stand right on top of that. Let's instead throw one oak in there. I'm gonna get my thermometer just to make sure that all of these going correctly, because we only have one ender pearl. I would very much like it if this didn't go completely 100% wrong. I thought I saw, the Britannia flowers do contain some Precantia, which I think I'm gonna use, because although these ender flames are not the easiest thing to make, and that right now they're a lot more less valuable. They're all less valuable than our ender pearls, so I'm going to use this for the time being. So let's have a quick scan on here. Can I see what's inside of this by scanning? I was really hoping I could. Also, apparently crucibles contain it. What? So can I just do okay, one second. Instead of using our ender flame, which is going to take a bit of time to replace, what we could do is just take some of our iron plates, which we have in abundance, craft those up into a crucible like so, into a cauldron like so, throw that cauldron down. I should probably set up another block over here for my wand. Where did I put my Thaumcraft wand? Is it in? Oh, it'll be in my table. It will be in my table. It is. Let's take this. Let's click on here. Make that into a crucible. This should now be worth 4 Precantia. And so if we take this, which we can do once we get rid of the silkworm, we should now be able to make the silverwood without using our ender flames or our ender pearls. So let's back up a little bit. The oakwood doesn't seem to have gone in. So we'll add that in. I'm going to add one more just to be on the safe side here, because it doesn't look like it's quite going in. You know what? Let me put these on my inventory. We're going to take you, you, and you. Let's throw in one of these. Like that. One lead. Like that. One crucible. Like that. And then one birch. Like that. Nice! And that gets us one silverwood log, which we can then use over here in the mana pool to get one silverwood plank. One thing we do want to make sure we do before we try doing that, though, is picking up all of the endo flames, because if you don't, you'll throw it down. The endo flames will just eat the silverwood log and use it for fuel. That is not what we want. I should really clear out my inventory real quick. Let me just double click on this over here, clear a bit of space. And now, if we throw this into here, we should get ourselves some nice silverwood planks, which we can now craft up with some golden ingots to get ourselves 2 V filters, I believe. Which I think we have to do over in the arcane crafting table, and then we should be pretty much good to go to make our distillery. So let's throw our wand back in there. Our wand is almost full on all the aspects apart from aqua. There we've only got 20, and ignis actually. We've only got 20 out of 25 on aqua and ignis, but if we throw you in the middle and gold either side, that's going to get us the V filter, and then all we need is to put a bucket in the middle, put iron ingots around it, and then I think one more gold on the side in order to make that work. We do so. Let's come and grab one gold, and let's grab 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 iron, I think it is. And if we throw all that together, that should get us the Arcane Limbic. Nice. So we'll take this out, and then we can use this now to go ahead and make ourselves the distillery. So let's put you in the middle. We want to put the mana steel all around the edges like so. We want to put the attuned stone at the bottom. We need 2 more gold for either side of that, and then we need 1 whiff of magic to go in the top left. And then the final thing that we need is the Odor of Purity. For that, we are going to require a hawthorn sapling. And so what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to go away. I'm going to make some more mutandis. You don't need to see me make it again. I think I made it like 2 or 3 times in the last recording session. So I'm going to go away, make some more mutandis, use that mutandis to try and get a hawthorn sapling. I'll then farm hawthorn saplings for a couple of minutes, try and get a nice amount of hawthorn saplings going. I'll then use those hawthorn saplings in the witch's oven until we get 1 odor of purity, and I'll be back in a second. And a lot of smelting in the witch's oven later, we now have 2 odor of purity. We can take one of those, bring them back over to our crafting table, and use them to finalize the recipe for the distillery, which we can now take and put down anywhere, I think, within like a 16 block radius of our altar over here. So for now, I'm going to put it down just right about there, and we're going to use this thing to make some of the other items required to make the chalk. So, for example, we need to make some gypsum. In order to make gypsum, we need foul fume, quicklime, and a clay jar. Foul fume is is made by putting oak wood into a witch's oven. So let me quickly grab a little bit of that. And then quick lime, I believe we can make fairly easily by crafting wooden ash into quick lime. That's all it is. It's just wooden ash crafted up. So let's put a couple of, just put a stack of that in there for now. Let's take a few of these clay jars out of here and stick them into the distillery like so. We are going to need, I think it's 2 gypsum to make this work. So we have to have this recipe run through twice. Let me quickly also craft up a little bit of quicklime. You know what? I'm going to craft the 2 for now. I'll craft both of those and stick those in like so. And then the other thing that we're going to have to craft is the tear of the goddess. And to get this, we need to put a breath of the goddess into the distillery with 1 lapis lazuli and 3 clay jars. So all we need to do really now is wait a little while until we get some foul fume. And a few minutes later, now that we've got 2 of those, we can take the wood out of here, stick some more birch saplings in there, try to not get set on fire. The birch saplings are going to get us the breaths of the goddess that we need in order to make the other goddess one, the tears of the goddess. So we'll use those in just a second. Whilst we wait for those, let's come over to here. Let's stick down our foul fume. That should all combine up nicely to get us our first 2 gypsum, which we can then use to make the chalk. And then once this is done, we should be pretty much good to go. Again, let me do a quick inventory dump here because we have a ton of stuff in our inventory right now that we don't need to be holding onto. And also, I kept one of these birch saplings because I don't want to have to go through the hassle of making more mutandis to try and get 1 more birch sapling. So let's put you in there for now. Quickly snack on some applesauce while we wait for all of this to finish. And there we go. We got 1 of those. This thing is taking its sweet time, but it's almost there. I'm fairly certain we don't need more of 2 of those. Let's just wait for this to finish. And once it's done, we now have the 2 gypsum that we need, as well as 2 extra slime balls and 2 oil of vitriol, which I'm assuming will come in useful later on down the line. Now all we need to do is put our breath of the goddess at the top, lapis in the middle, let that run 1 more time. And once that's done, we now have our tear of the goddess, as well as an extra whiff of magic and an extra foul fume for later on down the line. We can also take some of our wood ash out of here, and now we should have pretty much everything we need to craft up the ritual chalk here, and then almost everything we need to go ahead and make the alchemy catalyst. Let me quickly get rid of, I guess, more silkworms. We don't really need those. So let's put our 2 gypsum in the middle. Let's put our wood ash all around the outside. Let's put our tears of the goddess at the top. That gets us to a normal ritual chalk. Then in order to craft that into golden chalk, we need a mandrake root, golden nugget, and said ritual chalk. So we do have a mandrake root. Let me quickly grab a golden nugget from in here, and also let me quickly again dump a bunch of stuff out of here. We don't need this, or this. Don't need a sign or the hawthorn saplings for the time being. Let me just get rid of those. All right, let's bring these back over here, and let's craft that gold that we didn't pick up into a golden nugget like so. And now we should be able to craft all of that up fairly easily. Our cauldron is empty because I used it fairly recently for making the mutandis. So let's just quickly fill that up. And once it's full, all we need to do is throw in all of these. I don't know if it has to be in order or not, but I like throwing them in order just to be sure. So we'll throw in 1 mandrake root. We'll throw in 1 golden nugget like so. And then we'll finish that off with 1 normal ritual chalk. And that should combine up into what we're after. Maybe. We might have to update our altar, because I know a couple of things within which we do rely on the altar. If we look inside the altar here, you can see right now it's at 110. That number determines what stuff, what machines from which we around it can do. Right now at 110, I don't know if we can actually make the golden chalk. We might have to get it up to a higher level in order for that to work. It does. So a quick look on the wiki tells me that I need 2,800 to be the number inside of the altar in order for this to work. So we have a little bit of work to do before that can happen. According to the wiki, one of the things that can boost it is a mob skull. So if we put this down, does that work or does it need to be a normal? It might have to be a skeleton and like an actual skull in order for that to work. Do we have any skeleton skulls whatsoever, or we've only got heads? Let me look here. Skull. We do, we have 2 skeleton skulls over here. I'm not quite sure why we've got 2 in there, but none over in the mob spawning chest. That makes little to no sense, but if we put this on here, that should go ahead and increase the number a little bit. It's now at 220, and the ritual is still not working. Another item that we can apparently use is the chalice. The filled chalice does give you more, but for that, we do need some redstone soup, which I don't know if we can make. We need tongue of a dog, we need belladonna flower, drop of luck, wool of a bat. Jeez, we need a lot of stuff to make that happen. For now, let's just look at making the normal chalice. For this, we need 2 gold, 4 golden nuggets, and another attuned stone. That should be fairly easy, seeing as we were given a whiff of magic from that recipe there. So Let's quickly grab a diamond, make that into a mana diamond. Getting a bucket of lava is, of course, super easy in itself. Let's just quickly craft up another bucket. And one more attuned stone later, we now have the chalice. We can quickly throw this down on top of the altar. And according to the wiki, this is another multiplier of the base amount. So we put that there. That takes up to 330, which apparently is still not enough to get this witch's cover, this witch's cauldron here to actually work. I don't know if there's actually a whole lot else that we can get to make this work. So, let me look into this, guys. I'll be right back. Okay, so way too long later, and we now have this massive mess around our altar. And that is because, according to the wiki, the altar increases in its kind of internal point system the more it's around nature, like trees and grass and plants and saplings, etc., etc. And it's done a pretty good job. We're up to 2,877 points within the altar now, although it is a complete mess. But it's... Oh, wow, it's actually crafting. Okay. I thought it was... I did some testing in a single-player world because I got to 2,800 and it wasn't working. And so I figured that you might need 3,000 in order for it to work, but it turns out it's around 2,877 because it has just crafted. That is a bit weird. Although, one thing I did figure out and one thing I will tell you guys who are also going to try and do this is don't do what I've done here and make a complete mess of a bunch of different stuff. Instead, just use dark oak saplings because for some reason, dark oak saplings do significantly better than all the rest of these. On a single-player world, I cheated in 4 dark oak saplings, put them all down. You need 4 dark oak saplings to make 1 dark oak tree, but if you do that and then grow the dark oak sapling, for me it took it straight up to 2,800 instead of requiring all of this junk. And by the way, you can actually make dark oak saplings in an ex nihilo barrel with some normal oak saplings and some witch water, so it's fairly easy to do and a lot easier than all of this garbage that we have over here. But we do now have everything that we need, including the chalk. In fact, we don't have everything we need just yet. We're almost there though. If we go back to the alchemy catalyst here, we need 4 living rock, which we've got. We now have the golden chalk. I was using sand, rotten flesh, and sapling, by the way, in order to make all the dirt that we use. It's a lot easier than putting all of the dirt into the barrels over there. And now that we've got the mob spawner, we have a ton of spare rotten flesh just kind of lying around. So, we want to put the golden chalk in there, I think, in the top. And let's quickly grab some blaze powder. I did stick a bunch of those into the compressor. So we now have 12 blaze rods, which we can craft up fairly easily into a blaze lamp like so. We can stick that at the bottom. We can stick you at the top. We can grab our 4 living rock and stick those all around the edges. Thankfully, we do have 4, which is good. We'll stick them in the corner. So now the only things that we need are the 2 alchemical chemistry sets and the 1 Sailless Mundus. So I think we'll start with the Sailless Mundus just because it's the harder of the 2 to get. To get this, we need a balance shard. To get that, we need an air shard as well as all of these aspects. What I normally do is I normally find all of these aspects just in the other shards. Like I'll throw a fire shard in there. I'll throw a water shard in there, an earth shard, an order shard, an entropy shard, and then finally an air shard. Because we don't have all of those shards, what I think I will do is... I'm going to go away real quick. I'm going to look through my Thaumonomicon here and try and find a bunch of different items that contain all of the stuff that we need in here. So some Ignis, some Aqua, some Terra, some Order, and some Entropy. And then finally, I'll craft up an air shard. To do that, all we have to do is break a sandstone slab with a hammer. Just for reference, the way that you make that is a little weird. If we go and do something like this, that gets us sandstone. We then need 3 sandstone, I believe. And then I think we have to actually craft that sandstone into sandstone slabs. I'm going to do it over in this crafting table, just so we can leave that other one there with the stuff in it. If we do something like this, that gets us sandstone slabs. You then got to put these down like this and then break them in order to actually get the shards. But if I was to break that with a hammer, that should, and that enderpearl is, that enderman, which is a walking enderpearl, is driving me insane. I'm keeping him around just so we can capture him once we've got all this stuff up and running. But if we grab a normal exahilo hammer and break this stuff, this should give us, I think, an air shard pretty much every single time. Yeah, there we go. That's our air shard. So I'm going to go away. I'm going to try and find the items that contain all those aspects. Throw them all into the crucible, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, so a little digging around in the Thaumonomicon later, and we figured out the cobblestone contains both Predito and Terra. So if we throw 2 of those in, that's 2 birds with 1 stone done there. Lead contains Ordo, so 2 of those gets us the 2 Ordo. Charcoal contains 2 Ignis, so if we throw that in, that's the 2 Ignis covered. Water buckets contain 4 Aqua, so if we throw that in, that's the water covered. And then finally, if we throw in the air shard, that should get us the balance shard. I am then going to quickly empty out this thing because it is full of aspects, and it's going to give us a bunch of flux like that. Okay, I'll clean that up in a second once we've done the rest of the stuff. And now all we need to do is smelt up this balance shard. That's going to get us the Sailor's Mundus. And then finally, the last thing that we need is to make those two alchemical chemistry sets. So let's quickly throw you in the middle. Let's go and grab one of the alchemical chemistry sets from over here. Let's just pick this one up because we don't really need it right now. We can always make another one in the future if we do need it. And then to make a second one, all we need to do is get ourselves the brewing sand, which is just 3 stone slabs and 1 blaze rod. So if we once again come back over here, grab ourselves a blaze rod. Let's grab at least 3 normal stone, which I think I might have put back in here. I did. Let's take all of those. Again, let's take them over to our arcane crafting table just so we can leave the other stuff over there. By the way, I do plan, well, the fire is doing a pretty good job of it for me, but I do plan on getting rid of most of this stuff between episodes, so it's not just a complete mess over by this witch's altar. And what I'll probably do is replace it with the dark oak tree and see if it has the same effect in this world as it does in my single player world. That thing, I'm hoping that Enderman doesn't set on fire. I would like him to stick around so we can use him, but let's see if I can find my sacrificial orb. And once we got the division sigil and the sacrificial orb, let's see if we can get this thing up to 2500 whilst also not dying to that enderman. We can. And then let's throw in the brewing stand. That should very quickly turn into an alchemical chemistry set. Once it does, we can take it, run it back over to our crafting table, and we finally have everything it takes to make the alchemy catalyst here. We throw those down like that. That gets us the alchemy catalyst. We can now throw this down underneath our mana pool here, like so. And now we can craft up a bunch of extra stuff that we couldn't craft up before in the mana pool. For example, we can now turn our gas tiers into ender pearls. I have no idea if we'll have enough. We do not at all. We have 1 gas tier over in this chest, which is ridiculous. But we can now throw this into here, turn it into an ender pearl, and then use those ender pearls to craft up the auto-spawn a safari deck that we need in order to start spawning Enderman. So what I'll do between episodes, guys, I will leave this running. I'll make sure we have at least 2 more gas tiers by the time we come back for next episode. And at the very beginning of next episode, I will use those gas tiers to make a reusable safari net, try and capture an Enderman. I don't think we're going to be able to capture the one that is currently dashing around all over the place, but I'm sure we'll find another one. We'll capture that, stick it in the auto-spawner, and start automatically spawning Enderman for infinite ender pearls. But for now, guys, I'm going to end this episode of Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved Skyblock there. As always, if you did enjoy the video, be sure to like, it really does help out a lot. Leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys